Hello everyone, hope you are fine. So this is Akhilesh here. So in this session we are going to discuss quantile regression. Here we will discuss what is quantile regression, how it differs from other traditional regressions. Also we will see why we are going to use quantile regression, what are applications of quantile regression, what Python libraries are available. We'll use some samples and we'll use Python libraries to create a quantile regression. Okay, so let's switch to next slide. So first of all, what is quantile regression here? So quantile regression is a statistical technique used to estimate the relationship between predictor variables and specific quantiles of the response variable. In traditional regression, we predict the mean, but here we are going to predict the quantile. Let's say for example, for me, I have set up data, but for me, outliers are very important. So I will divide my data in the quantile. It means that I will not predict the mean, but I will predict the quantile of that in that outlier region. So that is the difference, that in traditional regression, we use to predict conditional mean. Here we predict the conditional quantile. Okay, so this quantile regression is nothing. It extends the traditional least squares regression, which focuses on the estimating the conditional mean of the response variable. But in the quantile regression, we predict the conditional quantile. Okay, so hope it is clear that in traditional, we are going to predict mean, but in quantile, we are going to predict the quantile of the response variable. So first of all, if you are not aware about the quantile, so let's discuss that what is quantile here. So quantile is nothing, just you are dividing your data in equal group. For example, if you see this normal distribution here, right? So it is divided in 25% percentile, then 25%, 25%, then next 25%. Percentile is nothing, that is the quantile, right? So this shows this is the first quantile, then second quantile, then third quantile, like this we can divide. So using quantile regression, what we can do, I don't care about this. This is not important for me. I want to predict this region only, in this region only. So this is what will I do? While creating a regression, I will provide that predict 25 percentile for me. So this way we will be able to control the region of our data, that in which quantile we are going to predict our output. So in quantile regression, the goal is to estimate the conditional quantiles of the response variable. Like we discussed before, a quantile represents a specific point in a distribution, such as the median, like 25 percentile or 75 percent. Quantile is nothing, just a percentile, but there is some range there, right? So if I am talking about percentile, it can be a point. Like I am saying here, in this case, let's say for example, what is the 25th percentile? Somewhere it will come here, and this region is what? First quantile, then second quantile, then third quantile. So four part are here, so it can be called as a quartile also. Okay, so we understood. So where to use the quantile regression? If you have a heteroscedasticity in your data. So if your data is heteroscedastic, then in that case, you are not going to use the linear regression. Either you need a more data or some kind of transform you need to do. But here, it doesn't matter. So you see in this graph, in this side, so you see that there is a heteroscedasticity. So how it happens? Let's say that in a company, there are two group of people. One group is earning less, another is earning higher than the other group. So of course, who is earning more, they will spend more. Who are earning less, they will spend less, right? So if you have to create a regression model, earning with spend with respect to earning. So what will happen? This will come in the group one, who are earning less and spending more. So in this case, x axis is earning and y axis is spending. So here, so your data is spreading, your error is spreading. And this is the reason is that guys who are earning more spending also more, right? Guys who are earning less, they are spending less also. You see that this is reduced, right? And this case, you see this green one, that is 5 percentile. So what I wanted to say in this case, that I want to predict in this, this is very important for me, this green line, I don't want to predict this part. I mean this just below one, which we have, okay? This part. Okay. Or maybe I want to predict above 95 percentile, this data, maybe this line I want, or this line, but I don't want this line in this case. So here we can control our data, we can control our output. So sometimes predicting the central tendency is not important. Central tendency means mean, median, or mode. Sometimes we need to predict in some specific reason. So by estimating different quantiles, one can gain insights into different parts of the distribution, not just the central tendency, right? Doesn't matter, I want in this region, or this region, I can do. So when to use quantile regression? We already saw one example in the next previous slide. So quantile regression is particularly useful when the data exhibit heteroscedasticity, varying levels of dispersion. Like you see, we have the dispersion here in this case, right? Here we have less. Okay, so when the distribution of the response variable is asymmetric or has outliers, so doesn't matter your data is a heteroscedastic. In a distribution, it can be a normal distribution also, it can be with some outliers, there can be some skewness in your data also, you can use quantile regression. So it allows a more comprehensive understanding of how the predictors affect different part of the response variables in the distribution. So what it means that I can use quantile regression, how the my response is behaving, how the predictors are behaving with respect to response is different reason of my distribution, right? So that's a very good way to even to understand that if I have the predictors in 25 percentile how it is behaving, in 75 percentile how it is behaving, right? Okay, so there are some applications of quantile regression, like financial analysis, like providing insight into tail risks, like if you have spent some money, stock prices, or you want some returns from there. So in stock prices, mostly your risk happens in the tail side, and I want to do analysis in the tail side. I want that my model will predict the risks there, then I can use the quantile regression. Okay, so in economics also, like we discussed that what is your income, and with respect to expenditure, of course, more income, more expenditure, less income, less expenditure. Healthcare, like such as the length of hospital stays or medical expenses, as many days you will spend in hospital, if you're staying in the hospital, your spend will increase. So again, there will be an imbalance. It's not normally distributed with respect to day and your spending in the healthcare, let's say, for example. Environmental studies, like ecological responses, like species, abundance of biodiversity indices, of course, you can use in that environmental studies also. Or social science, like such as educational attainment, crime rates, right? So in some specific region, there are different crime rates. In other region, there are different crime rates. Or job satisfaction, that how much you are satisfied. Most people are satisfied, but less people are not satisfied, for example. So in that case, you want to predict that area where the employees are not satisfied. So again, you will go for the quantile regression. So it's kind of magic, right? So let's switch to the Python here, not spending more time. Okay, so I am using a notebook for this. So first of all, we are going to import important libraries here. So like NumPy, Matplotlib we are going to use, sklearn library we are going to use from the linear regression, because we are going to compare with the quantile regression. So we have here quantile regression library, we have the linear regression, and we will estimate the mean absolute error and square errors also to compare that which one is better, and when to use linear regression and when to use the quantile here. Okay, so next step, I am going to generate data. So you can have your own data. So I am going to generate a synthetic data. So in my case, the data will be something like that: distance covered by different vehicles. So 200 vehicles, let's say I have. So and they have covered the different distances. unit doesn't matter in this, because this is synthetic data. With respect to distance, how much emissions happens from that vehicles? That is our target. Input is distance, target is emission from the vehicles. So 200 samples I am going to generate here. Okay, so when I generate using linear spacing, then I will use this linear equation, then I will get without heteroscedasticity. So I have to generate some noise to get disturbance in my data. Okay, so here simply I am using this normal generator. So from NumPy, so let me maximize this here. So what is the mean and scale and all that inputs I am providing, and simply generating, and then I am adding it here. That's very simple. Okay, so let me run this part and this part, and then in this Y we are going to add the noise. So if you see here, if I plot simply X and Y, let's see what we are getting here. So simple, so there is no noise, right? Or let do a scatter plot. In this case, plt dot scatter. So you see, this is straight line, right? When we add this noise, for example, and we are going to use this noise to plot this, and you see that heteroscedastic is there, right? Data is spreading, so your error is spreading in this case. Perfect. In other way, we can use some different kind of plotting ways. We can plot the X levels, Y levels, we already know, we need not to discuss about that. So okay, so here two graph I am showing you. The first graph is, of course, this is the mean, the Y which we have generated, and this is with the noise, the dotted line, which is heterostatistic data, and this is nothing, just a difference between the noise and the mean. So residual distribution for heterostatistic, normally distributed targets. This is a residual, so the error-added data subtract the without noise data. So that's the how this is normally distributed at zero mean, the perfect, right? Okay, so we have this issue here. So when dealing with the heterostatistic, normally normal distributed target is observed that the variance of the noise increases as the value of the features X increases. Also, we can see here also, when we increase the Y, when we increase the X values, then our noise will also increase, errors will also increase, right? We can see here, right? Perfectly. Okay. So now we are going to use quantile regression. So what I am going to do, there are different kind of solvers available here. So I am going to create a quantile regression for 5 percentile, 50 percentile, and 95 percentile. So simply, this is nothing, just a quantile, 50 and 95. Okay, so here I have already loaded a library above, so we are using this library here. And if I press the control tab, we can see what kind of solvers are available here, right? So just 1 minute. Yeah. So what parameters we can provide, quantile, alpha value, we need an intercept or not, what kind of solvers do we want. So different kind of solvers are available. If you design from scratch, then you can use advanced solvers like genetic algorithm, particle swarm. It's so new that what you are going. So here is this. These are different kind of solvers. Like interior point is there, right? So I am using highest here, and nothing. I am just using this quantile regression, and I am generating. I am going to saving that data in this prediction as a dictionary. So here I have to create a dictionary. So I will first create a model on 0.05, then 0.5, then 0.95 percentile, and then I am going to save it here. And then later we are going to plot that all. Okay. Also, we have some conditions here to show the outliers. I mean, lower, that is below 5 percentile and below 5 percentile and above 95 percentile. So we are saving it here with some condition. So we need not to discuss about that so much. Okay, I'm going to run this and see our model will learn 3 times for 3 iterations, and QR is nothing, just a model. So if you want intercept, just you can get intercept, and let's say you want a coefficient. In our case, coefficient will be for what? Distance. Right, distance is input and emission is output, so this is the coefficient, right? So lots of informations are available in this model, depends on you, what do you want from this. Okay, score you can calculate. Okay, so here we have this model, and now we are fitting and we are predicting it. So now what we are going, the mean, the actual without adding the noise at 5 percentile, 50 and 95, all we are going to plot it here. So let me just plot it, so all we can see here like this. So see, this is as 50 percentile, right? So this dotted line which you see, that is the true mean of the data. So if I have to use the linear regression, my result will be something like that, which we see that dotted line. And this is nothing, 50 percentile is nothing, it is the median, right? So this is your median. So you see that it is more robust, more this side, and from here you can see more it is below, right? And this is at 95 percentile green one, and this graph which is predicted one, it is coming at 5 percentile, and the plus one that are is still above that, and this is just below that, right? So what I wanted to say, this is surprising, isn't it, that I want to predict the outliers only, right? So maybe I can represent like this, right? This green one, this outliers, or maybe I want, let's say my outliers are somewhere at 5 percentile. So I just want to predict near the 5 percentile, because that is important for me. Maybe I want to predict some kind of loss there, maybe my loss or some risk is there in that distribution, so I want to predict. So that's very good, right? Okay, so this is the way. So let me rephrase this again, let me explain this again. So we are using this quantile regression, linear regression, and absolute and mean absolute error we are going to compare in the next one. So simply here I am going to use quantile 0.5 here, so 50 percentile. Okay, solver I am going to use same, and here I am going to create a linear regression as well as quantile regression, and then we are going to compare mean absolute error and mean squared error of both. And you will see the surprising result here. You see here, mean absolute error for linear regression is 2.202, but for the quantile regression it is 2.196, and this is lesser than the linear regression. So it depends on you that what is important for you, mean absolute error as a cost function or mean squared error. If you see mean squared error here, linear regression is giving the better result than quantile regression. So it's on you again. So what will be your cost function based on your data, what you are going to regress that, based on that you are going to decide this, right? So if you want to more information, you can use ChatGPT, ask, it will give you all explanations whatever you want. Okay, so that's all for today, and just comment it, and later maybe in the next session or when I make a video, there we are going to discuss the theory behind it and how theoretically the algorithm, what is the algorithm inside that, we are going to discuss. So thank you everyone, and bye, take care, and don't forget to subscribe my channel if you want some new videos on that, or some other videos on different languages or something. We'll see later, right?